Thank you, Madam Chair. Good morning, excellencies and distinguished guests. I'd like to thank the government of India and UNCTED for their warm hospitality today. My organization, Mythos Labs, uses media and technology to combat violent extremism, misinformation, and online harm. We're privileged to have conducted counterterrorism programs around the world, funded by many of the governments and UN agencies represented here in this room. Today, I'd like to draw your attention to the threats posed by terrorist exploitation of two new technologies, AI-based content generation and the decentralized metaverse. Vladimir Lenin once said, "There are decades when nothing happens, and there are weeks when decades happen." Well, in the world of artificial intelligence, the last few weeks have seen decades of progress. Today, anybody with an internet connection can access commercially available powerful AI language models like GPT-3 in order to instantly generate human-like text in any language, on any platform, and on any topic. If that sounds hard to believe, you may be surprised to know that the last few sentences I just read out, beginning with the Vladimir Lenin quote, were not written by me or by any other human. They were written by AI. Terrorists can use these powerful AI models to generate endless amounts of persuasive propaganda. And though the main models like GPT-3 do have safety measures in place to try and prevent that, copycat models of tomorrow may not. While AI-based content generation could arm terrorists with an ability to create propaganda, the decentralized metaverse offers them new ways to use it. In a virtual metaverse where people interact through avatars that can move in three dimensions, see, hear, touch, and even smell their surroundings, terrorist propaganda can take any number of forms beyond the traditional text, image, and video of today. And in such an unregulated and highly interactive environment, terrorists could find new ways to not only meet and coordinate with one another, but to radicalize and recruit others as well. So what do we do about it? How do we fight back? Firstly, we must build media and information literacy. Content moderation is important, but it's not enough. Instead of pretending like we can remove all terrorist propaganda, we should build the public's resilience to it. Teaching people how to identify, how to report, and how to defend against extremist propaganda reduces radicalization. I recently met a young woman in East Java, Indonesia. She had joined ISIS as a teenager. She flew all the way to Syria, and she told me she got radicalized by a recruiter on Facebook who used to send her 15, 20 Facebook messages every hour until she finally responded, thinking that's the only way to get him to stop. I asked her, I said, "Why didn't you just block him?" And she says, "What's blocking?" If somebody had taught her how to block a Facebook user, basic media literacy, maybe she wouldn't have joined ISIS. That's why, and also there's a real appetite for media literacy among populations. I know that because last year, right here in India, Mythos Labs created SMILE, the social media and internet literacy e-module that teaches young internet users how to protect themselves online. SMILE has an edutainment approach. It features several videos starring a local influencer explaining concepts in a fun but informative manner. And each video is followed by a quiz. Now, this edutainment-based approach to media literacy seems to have resonated with young people. SMILE has been incorporated into the curricula of 35 schools across the country. It's been taken by tens of thousands of students, and we're expanding it to other countries across Asia, Africa, and Europe. Secondly, we must counter viral lies with viral truths by creating the kind of counter messaging and inoculation content that young people actually want to watch. Young people today have access to an unlimited amount of entertaining and free content right here on their phones. So why would they ever choose to watch something that's not entertaining? That's why at Mythos Labs, we partner with comedians to create humor-based campaigns that debunk terrorist narratives. As the great comedian George Bernard Shaw once said, if you want to tell people the truth, make them laugh. Otherwise, they'll kill you. In conclusion, while the challenges of terrorist exploitation of new technologies like the metaverse or AI-based content generation may seem very daunting, if we recognize and act on them now, we still have time to get ahead of them and to ensure a safer tomorrow. Thank you all very much.